Thanks for joining me. I expect you've attended your fair share of funerals. Final goodbyes are usually tough. The funeral of a young person or someone who was taken in tragic circumstances can be very difficult. You miss someone who is gone, and you should. Grief is important, necessary, but it's not easy. So wouldn't it be great if somehow we were able to get back the people we'd lost to death, loved ones, family members? In spite of its many advances, science has done nothing at all to bring someone back from the dead. God, on the other hand, has done plenty. In the Bible, you'll read of the story of Lazarus, the story of the son of the widow of Nain, of Jairus' daughter, of the centurion's servant, very much dead and then brought back to life by Jesus. There are others, the son of the woman of Shunem in 2 Kings, the man whose body was hastily deposited in the grave of Elisha. A band of Moabite invaders was approaching, so those burying the man hurriedly put his body into Elisha's sepulcher. And when his body touched Elisha's bones, the man revived. He came back to life. You can imagine what the men who buried him were thinking. Now, this is Jesus speaking in Revelation 1, verse 18. I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore, amen, and have the keys of hell and of death. You see what Jesus says? He has the keys of death. He has the keys of the grave, which is what that word hell means in this verse. There's no coming back from death except through the power of Jesus. There's no staying dead forever if a person dies in faith in God. When Jesus has your heart, death is then temporary. Faith in Jesus is the way back from the grave. I'm John Bradshaw, for It Is Written. Let's live today by every word.